So yeah, four watches. Is it gonna become a new trend? I hope not. I really hope not. You see, I hate to be that guy, but someone has to tell that. When you wear two watches, even if one of those watches is just a smartwatch, it looks as ridiculous as me right now wearing four watches. It has to come from necessity. If you are in some kind of very harsh environment and you really need to see two time zones, and environment is so harsh that you can't even fiddle around with a single watch to see two time zones, so you slapped two watches of two different, even four watches, to see different time zones because you are in necessity, in very difficult situation, and you really need very practical way of seeing several different time zones. That's all right. But if you just casually slap two watches on yourself, that does look a little bit out of place. I mean, do whatever you want, whatever makes you happy. But it's wearing two watches, I mean, it's just as ridiculous as wearing four watches. So, sorry to be that guy, but someone has to tell you that. Anyway, this video is not about fashion. It's about these watches, Daytona homages, Pagani Design, no, Parnis and Pagani Design. I already did review on this black Pagani Design. I haven't changed my opinion about it. And I already did review on this Parnis with shiny bezel. Haven't changed my opinion about this watch. It's absolutely stunning. It looks incredible. And I really want to compare it right now with the same Parnis, but black bezel. Oh, that's gonna be interesting. And also, let's compare this black bezel Parnis with this Pagani with black bezel. Oh, that's gonna be fun. You know what? First of all, I'm gonna show you watches how they look on a person, so you will get, you know, a general view. Already did review on this watch, haven't changed my opinion. Still, a lot of fun. This watch has very strong fun factor. This is Parnis with that shiny bezel. And speaking about the shiny bezel, it's like the main point of this watch, the strong point of this watch, because it does look incredibly beautiful. I kind of struggle to give you a good look through the camera because it's very reflective, very shiny. I can only tell you one thing, that this watch looks a lot better in person than it looks in camera. So beautiful. And I really want to compare this watch to this Parnis with black bezel. It is a little bit loose for me right now because I have borrowed this watch from a friend. I'm not gonna adjust the bracelet because it's not my watch, so I'm just gonna hold it up a little bit with my finger behind the bracelet. But it's not better and it's not worse than the one with shiny bezel. It's just different. Pagani Design has some positive things over Parnis, and Parnis has some positive things over Pagani. And that's gonna be very interesting actually to compare them, because it all comes down to personal taste, completely subjective opinions, which one you're gonna prefer. Okay, let me show you differences up close. First of all, let's start with this one, which is the most different from the rest. And I'm gonna repeat myself. White markings on black bezel doesn't look really nice with black watch. White logo on black dial doesn't look all right. It should be gray. And this watch will look a lot better without date window. It will look a lot cleaner, more elegant, but with this white date window, it does look out of place. But the strong point about this watch is that it has beautiful black dial, which makes these silver rings just pop out, and it does look rich. Man, this white date window is just ridiculous. Yeah, it looks a lot better now. Another negative thing about this black dial watch is that, look, I put a finger on the glass on sapphire crystal, and it's like, it's ridiculous. It is visible on the white dial as well, but it's not nearly as bad as on the black one. Anyway, so different rings, black dial, silver rings, looks incredibly beautiful. Now let's look at this Pagani, which I think is very well balanced watch. It is stunning. It's wonderful. It's beautiful. And let me tell you why. Nothing looks like it was taken out from another watch. Looks like everything was designed specifically for this watch, all parts. And one thing that I was afraid of is that this white dial is gonna look like white paper, but no. In real, it looks just rich, it's just wonderful. It's shiny white dial. It has some kind of a lacquer finish on top of something. I really like it. It is beautiful. And right now I would like to compare it to this Parnis, which looks, at first glance, at first look, it looks very similar. But let me tell you the differences. Well, first of all, Parnis is a little bit smaller watch and it has cleaner design. It doesn't have date window, it has less text on the dial, and it doesn't have markings on 6, 9 and 3. And well, you might be surprised. You would probably say that I would prefer Parnis for myself, but no, I actually prefer Pagani. But why, I'll tell you a little bit later. Even though you might think that this is because of water resistance, because Pagani is rated to 100 meters and Parnis to 30 meters. But you know what, to be honest, I wouldn't really trust Pagani with 100 meters of water resistance. I would feel a little bit uneasy going with this watch into sauna or jacuzzi. I don't know, these pushers, they just don't feel very secured. I'm not sure. If I unscrew the crown, I can clearly see that it has a rubber seal, but with these pushers, I don't know. I miss that sense of security. I probably wouldn't take this watch to the sauna, even it has 100 meters of water resistance. So it's not about that. And speaking about this Parnis, what I like a lot about this dial, that it has polished out edges around those black rings. So inside of those black rings and outside, the dial is polished out those edges. It does look so nice. It doesn't appear that clear on camera, but when I wear this watch and look at the mirror, well, this one or this one, it's the same dial. So when I wear this watch and look at the mirror, these polished out edges just pop out. It looks so alive, so nice. And this is the main thing that I miss on this Pagani design. It's all right, everything is fine, but once you see this Parnis up close, those polished out edges, it's just next level, really, next level thing. And another difference is the dial itself. Also, on camera, they both appear the same. White dial, yes. Well, Pagani is white to the point where if you would take completely white paint and add a little drop of blue, then it looks even more white. That's how white this dial looks. It looks like it even has a little bit of blue tint, which I like very, very much. And this Parnis, it's not really white. It's like a little bit cream. It has a silver shine, kind of metal finish on top. And the tint, the shininess of this dial is the main reason why I prefer Pagani. And when I put this Parnis on the wrist, it's like, that's what I miss, a little bit of that liveliness of this white dial of Pagani. It's really noticeable in person. I don't know how it will come out on video, but, well, it's personal preference, completely just personal opinion, but this Pagani is just incredible. Okay, now, Parnis versus Parnis. Both are incredibly beautiful, well-balanced watches. Absolutely love them. In terms of a beauty, they are very, very beautiful. Now the strong points of the one with the black bezel. This black bezel is ceramic, so it's not gonna be easy to scratch. It's gonna be a lot more durable. And this black bezel does look very well balanced together with these black rings on the dial. And this shiny bezel, even though I personally prefer the shiny bezel, I think it makes the watch, it looks absolutely wonderful, especially on different straps, because with original bracelet, it kind of disappears a little bit, but when I put on different straps, it kind of pops out a little bit more. But in terms of cohesiveness, on fluidity of the design, etc., etc., I kind of wish that those rings on the dial were silver as well, like the bezel, like this Pagani design has those beautiful silver rings. Imagine if this one would have those silver rings. It would look a little bit more balanced. Right now they stick out a little bit, maybe too much, but I mean, it's still, in terms of a prettiness, this is still a 10 out of 10. I'm just, you know, raising questions, thinking out loud. You see, if there would be a question, which one would I choose? I just couldn't answer. How these watches look on different straps on a person, we'll show you later on. First of all, let's take a better look up close. This is how I wear this watch, on this silicone strap. It's super comfortable. Now this classy black and gray striped nylon strap. Of course it looks wonderful, very nice. Now this elastic nylon band, it's very, very comfortable. One of the most comfortable straps you could get. Oh yes, that's nice. How about this leather strap? It's very breathable, very flexible. Paid like €7.50, something like that. Kinda nice, I like it. So I'm not gonna show you how this Parnis looks on different straps because it's the same thing as this Pagani in general view. So I'm not gonna waste your time. Also, I already did review on this black Pagani, so if you wanna see how it looks on different straps, check the link in the description. And also did review on this Parnis as well, so if you wanna see how it looks on different straps, the link in the description. I just only gonna show you how this looks on this leather strap, just because I wanna show you how this bezel pops out of the picture and how much more alive it looks like in comparison to the original bracelet. Just a quick reminder how beautiful this watch really is. Just like, you know, casually, hands in the pockets. It doesn't really look that great on camera in comparison. In real life, it looks just insane. Such a beautiful watch. This Pagani with this leather strap, it looks like it belongs to each other. It's really nice. Really nice. And this is how I wear this Pagani on this silicone strap. That's how I like it the best. I like this blue silicone strap. And believe me or not, I have been already wearing this watch for almost 2 weeks, I believe. And no other watch. 2 weeks straight, just this single watch. That's how I like this watch. That much. This black and gray striped strap looks good on all watches, basically, but especially good on this one. Black and white, it just comes together so nicely. Really works together very well. Elastic strap, it feels good, it feels really good, and it's very easy to adjust, you know, loosen it up, tighten it up. Wonderful. And does look very nice with white dial. Anyway, amazing watches. So where do they go on thomaswatchreviews.com, where I rate watches in different tier lists? This one obviously goes into keepers, and this Parnis also goes into keepers. This one is already into keepers, and this black Pagani, well, now this is not bad. It stays in not bad. It has its flaws. I can't put it into keepers, even though it's a lot of fun. Anyway, I hope this video wasn't too boring. I hope I haven't insulted anyone in the beginning. Really, it's just my point of view. Okay, thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.